Hello everyone, welcome. So you are now watching the Camera Tommy lessons, and today you are going to see how we can model this chair from scratch in Blender. So we'll see how it can model and add the materials. So let's get started. Basically, I have added this reference. Feel free to gather all your reference. If you want to model the chair exactly, I will leave the reference images for this chair, and you can find a lot of reference online for this chair exactly. And let's get started by see that we have here an blade, and we have the four legs, and it's symmetrical, so we will make the benefit of the mirror modifier. So I will add an plane, and after that I will add thickness after scaling. So we say this may be 40 centimeter, I think. So let us say scale 0.5, so it's 1 meter. And if you want to make it exactly, so you type here 0.45, and after that I will move. Then I will select this plane and move in the 0.4. This is what we need, and I will add solidify modifier or add thickness as you'd like. So if you want to add solidify such as this, you can add in the other direction, and we can see that it's 0.03. If you want to work with centimeter, you can go to units, and from length it will be centimeter exactly, and 3 centimeter I think is enough for now. Let's add another bevel modifier. If you'd like, add the scale and bevel of 0.3, maybe 0.3, and here 5. So this is our base, and we can now add the legs. So it's angled, so we can select this point and add here, and let's add plane. It will be 4 by 4, and this one will be moved here 2 centimeter and move in the x -2. Then we will extrude, select all and extrude in the Z -40. This is fine. And we will move in the Y. It will be moved in the Y -2, -1. And what happens here? And maybe move in the X 1. Let's add mirror in this axis and in the Y, of course. This is fine. So we can select this face. Of course, it's selected. And after that, we can add another plane, which is 2, and rotate around X 90 degrees. Then extrude in Y up to this area. Scale and set 1.2, and mirror around the x-axis. So I will duplicate this one and delete the mirror, make the origin to the geometry, and rotate in Z 90 degrees. And after that, we can move in the x-axis. We can move here, select all and move here. This is fine. Move in Z.8. After that, I will add the bevel here. I will add the bevel and 0.36 or 0.37. This one also apply the scale, and after that I will add bevel, and this one will be like this. So what happens here? We want to adjust something, so I will apply on the let's duplicate this one and add on the Y, and I will apply this one. So we can select what happens here. Yes, we can select this one. So this is the front, and you want to mirror around the X. So we'll apply the X. So I have selected the leg, and I have added or applied all the mirror modifier, and after that I have added the bevel modifier. Basically, this one is shorter in the lens, so I will select all these and move in the eye. Then we can select the upper part and extrude in Z. Then feel free to extrude to this distance. And after that, I will move in the eye up to this area. Then we can select this edge and this edge, and or we can add loop cut here and another loop cut here. And slide, and the bevel. Select this one and this one, and duplicate, separate by selection, and select all and edge, bridge, edge loops. Let's see if there is any duplication, so that's fine. And I will scale in the Y, select all and scale in Y.1. So we have this separation that it's handmade. And after that, we can select this one or also and duplicate in this edge. How we can do that? So I will select this edge. The trick here, I will go to add this one, it's called line or in sync, and let's duplicate this one along the Y. So shift DY, and this is the coolest trick I have learned in the new version of 2.8 or 2.9. This trick will save you a lot of time, so you can add your own transformation or on your own gimbal here. You can add any as you would like. And we will make now that triangle. So let's go back to the global, and we can select this one and duplicate. So let's select this one and scale in the Y, scale in Y.5, and let us make the orientation geometry scale in Y.5 and the scale in Z.8 or 7. Apply the scale, don't forget, and rotate 90 degrees, and let's move here. Then you have the challenge to move this. I will move the edge here and let's select this one and this one and move here. And the mirror around the base or this around this, but let's add or set orientation geometry. You are now in the so you can flat it by scale in the axis, and this one also you can scale. All right, this is the same chair. How you can add materials. So if you are lazy, so you can choose one of the add-ons. This add-on is for free. It has 20, around 30 free materials procedural. It's I will leave the link also in the description. It's for free. And if you want to get the 2000 material, you can purchase it for around $20 or $25. So if you are in rush, you can select maybe the tone. So I will select all and duplicate this collection to make two version. So I'll duplicate the collection and let's move in the X. Here I will add some detail or here. Select this edge and separate add selection. What we have now is to extrude in the Z. Extrude. And the solidify will be as the other direction. And you can now scale in the X. What about mirroring? Is this in the Y direction? Will it do the job? Yes, it's doing the job. The same thing will be done here. So we can shift D and separate by selection, select this edge and let's move here. And after that, I will offset 3 centimeter. Let us make it 2. And this one, maybe 2 also. Yes, it's and after that, we can add the mirror around the X axis. That's fine. We are now ready to add material. As I've mentioned, if you are in rush, let's see, we can now add the stylized. Let's add this one, assign material. Of course, it's a wooden chair. And let's add for this one, assign material. Add assign existing or add a new copy. And other, okay. But let's unwrap the chair. So this is the stylized version. Of course, you can add the scale 2 or increase it 1.5. And this. Let's this is the width, of course. You can decrease it. Let us make it 1. You can change as you'd like. So this is the stylized version. And if you have the add-on which is here from this add-on has a lot of materials from the X3D, so you can go for wood and change it. It's procedural also. Let's select all and control L link materials. This one also, it doesn't need any UV unwrapping. It's all these add-ons are procedural. Yes, this one also will be linked. Okay, and this one also the same material. So what if we want to use image textures? So I will smart UV unwrap all these items. We can select and tab U smart UV, some margin here, and this one will be wood, and I will go in the shader editor here and let's use some images from the Polyhaven. So I think you are in Rush. Go to this website, which is Polyhaven. It has a lot of materials for free and HDRI and some models. So you can download this blend file. It has 8K, 4K, 2K, or 1K. I have chosen the 1K. And you can download this blend file and just append. You don't need to work on the material at all. So I will I will show you this method firstly. Then we can go to the second method of using the CG textures. So firstly, you go to the file, append, and after that go to textures, this file material, and just it. So you can choose this material which is here, and select all the materials and select this one, control L link materials. You can go now to see that you have this material. What happens here? So because it's solidify, so it's stretched. Let's apply the solidify here and re-unwrap, and it's now done. We don't need the reference at all. This is the procedural and this is with material. If you see this material is so big, you can, of course, you can choose the 2K. It will be fine. And you can go to the shader editor and increase the scale. Maybe 3. So let's see what we have. It's now. The scale is right and correct. And we are now done for this share. And I will show you now the setup. So this is the image and this is the roughness. If you want to set up it manually, and this is a normal map, or you can choose the round map. And if you want to choose make it realistic, you can go to the setting from here and choose displacement and the bump, and enable the experimental. And here in the subdivision, you should have some subdivision from here and adaptive subdivision of 3 maybe. For you should do that for all elements that have the displacement. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like this lesson. See you in the next video.